Give a Pig a Party, which is by the same author as If You Give a Mouse a Cookie, If You Take a Mouse to the Movies. It goes on and on and on and on, okay? Loosely based, not an exact interpretation. All of the children chose the part that they wanted to play. We've added some animals that maybe were not in the original, and that's okay too. No worries there. We don't care, right guys?
Yeah.
And just to let you know, we do, although this is first and second grade, we do have one fifth grader with us, Miss Julie here. Julie has been taking my classes for a couple years, and unfortunately the day of the week that was for third through fifth didn't work, and she really wanted to do it, so she's been helping me out, and you will see she has taken a little bit of a leadership role. It actually worked out great for me. If I could have a Julie every year, first and second, I really win. Look, Josh, I told you he would come. Go give him the paper, all right? And then now we have all of our audience members. Oh, he's so happy. He was so worried. Are you sure you gave him the email to send? I said, I promise. Great for mom too. Awesome. Okay, so how about I say places? Can everyone take their places for the show?
Places.
Now remember, we want to be nice and loud, right? I'm going to close this back door. Dismissal is going to happen. It gets a little loud sometimes. So we're going to be nice and loud. We want to look at the audience when we speak. Right? And we are here, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Places, come on.
If you give a pig a party.
A party? I love parties. We need balloons for a party. We need friends for a party. Let's call our friends.
Okay, hang on. Let me find some balloons that will call your friends.
Bunny.
Oh,